Yo, what's good, everyone? It's your boy. Today's video, we got a guest upload from Crush Cards, the coolest Yugi couple in the game. We're going to be checking out a super underrated deck this format. So, if you guys are excited for this video, aren't you going to smash the subscribe button, smash the like button, go check out TriffGaming.com for literally the most beautiful playmats in the universe, and go check out Crush Cards' channel in the link down below to check out their awesome content. And let's get started on a super underrated deck this format. Lair of Darkness, baby. Let's go.
What's up, everybody? This is Brian.
And I'm Logan. And this is Electrum. And we're Crush Cards. Hi, team. Happy whatever day it is for you, my ecstatic Electrumites. Yeah, I didn't know where that was going. I'm used to our channel. Hello, my pen best deck friends.
So this may not be your typical video, and it's definitely not Pendulum content. However, Triff actually asked us to do a deck profile for one of our favorite decks, just for the fun of it, I guess.
We typically cover a lot of rogue decks, and well, this deck, Lair of Darkness, was one of the first decks we picked up when we started playing the game, so we figured it was only fitting to be showing you guys this deck.
And just like Pendulums, it's A, structure deck, and B, super duper underrated, and actually clashed a lot of people. I've been bringing this deck to locals for like the last couple weeks or so now, and I've been going X1 every single week with it. My only losses have been to like stupid things, you know, like Konami not banning Imperial Order.
Or me. I was a couple of his losses too, because, you know, we always get paired together at locals. That's really fun. So I know this isn't a Pendulum deck, and I know this isn't something you guys are used to seeing on the channel, but we hope you enjoy it. Make sure you come subscribe to our channel, Crush Cards, and make sure you come hang out and join the sub squad. But with that being said,
before we get into this profile, make sure y'all are all hitting that subscribe button for Drift, smashing the like button, and putting in the comment section down below that Pen is obviously still just the best deck. This is just a rogue deck.
So with all that yapping out of the way, get your sunglasses on, grab your Electrumites, hug your Endymions, and let's get into this layer deck. I don't know what's going on, team. Anyway, moving on.
All right, so we're gonna do this deck profile just a little bit differently. As we said before, this is one of our favorite decks. It's the deck that got us back into Yu-Gi-Oh! 2 years ago. It helped us learn the mechanics. It's definitely not the greatest deck in the world, so take this with a grain of salt, but we know that when Triff's not playing Pendulums, he's playing Eldritch, which is a trap deck.
Trap decks are the best deck, shout out to Paleo.
So first off, we are playing double copies of Darkest Diablos. A lot of people actually play this card at one, which is totally fine, but this deck does honestly kind of lack like a win condition once you get into that really long grindy game state. So you do want to have two of this card, at least in our opinion, because you want to have a 3k boss monster, can't be targeted, rips a card out of your opponent's hand, special summons itself, and then when the field spells face up, like, you can tribute your opponent's stuff as well. Like, this is probably one of the best boss monsters ever printed out of a structure deck, next to Doom King and next to Endymion. I mean, like, this card's insane. Like, it's a dragon, it's level 8, 3k, can't be targeted. This card's wild.
Or tributed.
That's true. You can't nib this card.
You can't kaiju this card.
Facts.
Whack.
And then we're playing three copies of Arima. Arima is actually a really, really powerful card in this deck because you can discard it to search Lair of Darkness, which is the entire purpose for this deck. This entire deck revolves around the field spell, so getting your field spell is insane. So this is basically just like your sixth copy of the card.
He also tributes himself to draw a card. That's pretty powerful.
Or if Lair is face up on the field, you can tribute any dark monster and draw a card. So really cool because you can tribute your opponent's stuff because that's what the field spell does. So not only does this get you your field spell, but if you already have it, it interacts with your field spell also. It also can just search Diablos too. It's another effect. So this card has a ton of effects. And then the best card in the deck, not only in this deck, but in Eldritch, believe it or not, this card actually was specifically made for Lair of Darkness. It's Lilith. Lilith has the quick effect to tribute a dark monster, reveal three normal traps, and then your opponent randomly selects one and puts it on your field.
She's so good.
It does not search. It literally just sets. You can't ash this card. And the best part about Lilith is that if you don't have anything else or your opponent doesn't have anything, you can tribute this card to do that. So it just triggers itself. It's a quick effect. Once again, Lair of Darkness, really, really powerful because you can just do this on your opponent's turn. You get a trap, they lose a monster. The best part about Lilith is that it tributes for cost, so your opponent really can't respond to it. Like, so say your opponent has like a Dragoon and you activate Lilith tributing the Dragoon, they can't negate it with Dragoon because once this would actually go to resolve, the Dragoon is in the graveyard already. So really, really powerful. And then we are playing two copies of Malice. I know this is not like a standard Lair of Darkness card, but I actually really think this card is kind of mandatory, at least at one copy in the deck, because it's once again just a quick effect to tribute two monsters. If Lair is face up, you can tribute one of your opponents and itself, and then you get to recycle your trap. So any trap card that's in your graveyard or banished, you can set it to your field, and then once it leaves the field, it doesn't get banished, it doesn't go to the graveyard, it actually gets shuffled back into the deck. So you're like playing the grind game really, really efficiently by putting all your powerhouse traps back on the field and then back into your deck. Also, quick effect, really, really powerful.
Also really pretty. I love Malice. I think Malice and Lilith are two of like the prettiest design cards in Yu-Gi-Oh! Don't at me.
And then we're playing the one copy of Skarm. Literally, it just goes to the graveyard and it searches Malice or Lilith. And then the reason that this deck is so powerful is because we are playing the one copy of Artifact Scythe. You could turbo this card out, obviously, because Sanctum is a trap. You could search the trap with Lilith. We are also playing Trap Trick, so you could play, you know, Lilith into Trap Trick, into Sanctum, or you can just, you know, billions of ways to get this card. And then for our field spells, we are on quite a lot here. We're playing triple copies of Lair of Darkness. This is the entirety of the deck. It makes makes every monster on the field yours and your opponent's a dark monster, and then it has the ability to tribute one of your opponent's monsters if you were to activate an effect that tributes a card for cost. So once again, Lilith tributes to set, Malice tributes to reset, Arima tributes to draw, Diablos tributes to rip a card out of your opponent's hand.
And like, ruin your day.
This is literally the entire purpose of this deck.
Also, shout out to the whole core being Euro print.
Yo, facts. It's a dark deck. We wanted to have the darker print. Come on now.
The darkest of decks.
And then it also has the additional effect where the turn player at the end of that turn gets a torment token or tokens up to the number of monsters that were tributed. So say it was like my turn and I activate Lilith, tribute a card, I will get a token. Or if it's my opponent's turn, I activate Lilith, tribute one of their monsters. It doesn't matter whose monster is tributed. It's the turn player that gets the token. The really cool part is that the tokens are only 1,000 attack and defense, so you can like beat over them pretty easily, or you can also just use them as tribute fodder where your monsters can just tribute them to clear them regardless. And then this is a field spell deck, so we're playing probably the best field spell ever printed.
Wow, that is such a bold-faced lie for anyone who watches our stream. Brian hates this card.
I really do, but like in this deck you kind of need it. Mystic Mind tells your opponent they can't play, and this deck, it's not the fastest deck in the world, so we need some slow tempo cards. This is the tempo card. It's the best tempo card in the game. Speaking of field spells, we are playing double copies of Demise of the Land because, as we said, you literally need a field spell on field at all times. We're also playing Terraforming, and then spoiler alert, at the end we're just playing Metaverse. So
of course
we're playing a lot of field spells, and then Arima can search the field spell. This deck is literally almost dead if you don't have the field spell.
Well,
you can't play like more than a couple turns without the field spell, so making sure you have access to it is imperative.
What is Layer of Darkness without the layer?
It's just darkness.
darkness.
Demise is really good because it can like allow you to get Mystic Mind for interaction or lack of interaction, or it can get you Layer on your opponent's turn when they decide to play as well.
It's kind of cute because Mystic Mind looks like it's like in Layer of Darkness because they're in like a dark cave.
That's kind of wild.
It's
kind of
cute. Unintentional lore.
And then for consistency cards, we are on triple copies of Pot of Extravagance. Your extra deck is kind of pointless in this deck, so like drawing two is really strong. I know a lot of people like Prosperity. I still think drawing two cards, especially when you're playing a trap deck, you see trap cards more often. I would rather set two trap cards than search for like one decent card. You always want to have card advantage, and this deck needs it. And I mean, like, actually needs it.
Also, this card's cheaper than Prosperity.
Big facts. But you know it's not cheap? Three copies of Ultimate Rare Super Poly.
Wow.
Once again, Layer of Darkness makes everything on the field dark. This card is so free, it's not even funny.
That's pretty neat.
And then the last spell card is the one copy of Foolish Burial. You can send your Skarm, or you can send your Diablos, or we are playing some like Rebornable, trappy kind of things in here. So if you don't have access to Lilith or Malice or any other piece that you may need, you can just Foolish them to the graveyard, and then you can Reborn them regardless. And then moving off into the traps, I know that we're, you know, a little disorganized here when it comes to our layout, but literally like one of the best trap cards in the entire deck. Triple copies of Artifact Sanctum.
This
card just, it gets you Scythe, and Scythe says your opponent can't play the game. We're also on triple copies of Dogmatica Punishment. Also, just like all these trap cards are searchable. So your powerhouses, you want to play at three because you can just, you know, obviously draw into them. You want to see them turn one, even going second. These aren't like super terrible, because if you can like stick a layer and then Lilith tribute you like one of your opponent's problematic monsters, the Sanctum can actually put in a lot of work with the Scythe. Then you have like your entire engine rolling. You can Lilith tribute on your opponent's turn, grab Punishment, like it breaks boards, but just not like in one turn. But like once again, Punishment, it's literally like a 2-for-1, one of the best trap cards I think out there at the moment. Like this card is super strong, and Lilith, it's searchable. Malice, it's recurable. Every one of these trap cards is wild. And then back to the front, this card is so good.
Crazy.
In this deck. This honestly might be the second best trap card ever printed for this deck, at least, because this card allows you to special summon Scythe back on your opponent's turn. Once again, searchable off of Lilith. Like, you have so many ways to get to all of your trap cards. You are just looping Scythe. Like, there's a two-card combo with Lilith and Back to the Front where you just loop Scythe. Every single turn, your opponent can't touch their extra deck.
This layer may be dark, but it's eco-friendly. It's going green at Recycle.
And because this deck is slow, we are on double copies of Torrential Tribute and two copies of Trap Trick.
Shout out to Triff. He loves Torrential Tribute. If you didn't watch Duel Lights, make sure you go watch it. Wink.
We're only on two of these because this is a 41 card list. I love 41. I know, you know, 40 versus 40, gotta love to see it. We're 40 versus 41, and that's okay. But Torrential's really cool because if you don't have the actual engine rolling, you can still like have a searchable board wipe. You also have Trap Trick, which allows you to get any copy of any of your traps. And then like literally once again, Lilith. Like it's overkill, but Lilith. Like this card is the most insane card for the deck.
This deck really just wants to stall and stun and then just like win. That's it. It's a very simple deck. Straightforward. Love to see it. Anyway, extra deck.
For the extra deck, we're on the one copy of Almirage. Once again, your extra deck doesn't really matter because we are playing Extravagance, but this is like in case you have like, you know, nothing but Skarm, you can normal the Skarm, put this into the graveyard by like, you know, making the Almirage and then getting your search for the Lilith. So doesn't really matter. It's really just the card you're trying to banish off of Extravagance. Once again, doesn't matter. We're also playing double copies of Beat Cop from the Underworld. This actually has a relevant effect, believe it or not. If this card is Link summoned with two dark monsters that have different names as material, you can activate this effect, which is tribute one monster, then target one face-up card on the field, and you place a counter on it, and then basically if your opponent was to try to destroy that card with the counter on it, they have to get rid of the counter, and then the card will be destroyed. So, like, if you're trying to MST or, like, you know, Twin Twister the field spell, you have to do it twice, because this will protect it for one, which is really strong.
Who would have thought Beat Cop having a relevant effect in 2021?
And then the last Link is our one copy of Barricade Borg Blocker, literally just a generic Link 2. It allows you to recur your field spells, and then it also allows you to discard cards. One of your main avenues to go if you open up the Scythe, because you can just discard it, and then you can just search back to the front, and then special it back as well. So, really, really good card in the deck. Also, once again, billion times we'll say this, but like, Extravagance, you don't really play a ton of these cards. Cards you do play, though, are triple copies of Elder Entity Intus.
Our dance party, babe!
Triff plays Eldritch, you'll know exactly what this card does. And then we're playing double copies of our Mud Dragon of the Swamp.
Muddy boy.
Triple copies of Starving Venom Fusion Dragon, because, you know, Super Poly is like, absolutely
it's like,
insane.
It's like
in
an
this
indirect
deck.
Win con in this deck.
It really is. It's wild. And the reason we're playing Mud Dragon is because even if you do have Lair face up on the field, or if you don't, it takes two monsters with the same attribute but different types. So if Lair is up, they're all dark. It doesn't matter because Lair doesn't change the types. Or if you're playing like a mono attribute deck and you don't have Lair access, your Super Poly is still life. So really good Super Poly targets. And then the last ones in the deck, we're playing one copy of Dragoon and two copies of Raid Raptor Ultimate Falcon.
Oh.
I'm sure y'all can figure out what's in the side deck, but we'll hit that up in just
a
second.
Yeah, we're not playing the targets, but man, that side deck might have some for us. I don't know.
But yeah, this is basically just like an alternative win condition, especially in games 2 and 3, because, you know, Lightning Storm, Cosmic Cyclone, Harpy's Feather Duster, Twin Twister, like, when they think they're going to have the advantage, you just summon this 3,500 unaffected by the world card, and then you win.
And because we love all our pen players so much here at the Pen Gods Lair, Triff Gaming, we're going to show you all the side deck. You ready?
Side deck's a little wonky, but, like, once again, rogue deck, kind of wonky. Also, a structure deck, so we're not trying to make this the best deck in the entire game, but...
It's also built for our locals. We've been playing this at locals.
We're playing the one copy of our Artifact Lancia, because, you know, in case our opponent actually doesn't need their extra deck, our Scythe's kind of dead, but this is also a searchable card that you can special and then tribute, because, you know, for what it's worth, this card tributes from field. We are playing the one copy of Skill Drain for going first. I know this is kind of like a little weird interaction, but Skill Drain reads, activate by paying 1,000 life points, negate the effects of all face-up monsters while they are face-up on the field. That does not say they cannot activate, it just says that their effects are negated. Lilith, Malice, all of those cards tribute for cost, so you can still activate those cards, tributing your opponent's monsters, their effects just don't resolve. So you still get to like kind of like get rid of your opponent's stuff for free. And then, I mean, like, once again, kind of self-explanatory, playing triple copies of Waking the Dragon.
Who would have thought?
And then because it's a trap deck, we are siding double copies of Ice Dragon's Prison, just like kind of matchup dependent. There's some really like, you could play like the other copy of Torrential if you wanted. You could play like another copy of whatever. Like, we just wanted to have some utility because this deck kind of is like an anti-meta deck. You just want to have as many options as possible. So it's kind of a flex spot, but you know, do with it what you will. With some more 2-ofs, we're on two copies of Heavy Storm Duster, because once again, trap trick, you only really need two. Lilith, you can kind of search this. So if you're going up against a back row deck, this is just a really, really good out going first. And then going second for back row, we have double copies of Twin Twisters. And then for all of our combo decks, as we said before, you know, like, this deck doesn't really break boards. On one turn, it kind of needs to go throughout the course of a couple turns. So we are playing triple copies of Dark Ruler No More. And the reason you're playing this is because you just need the third copy of Mystic Mind to stick on the board. So really generic, really like easy. I think this deck is super easy to pilot. It's a really fun rogue deck. Definitely like really good for newer beginner players. Or if anyone is just interested in learning a new deck that's like, you know, not a tier one deck in this like kind of stale format already. This is a really, really cool option.
Yeah, this is a super versatile deck that can really make anyone happy at the end of the day. It's not the best deck like Pendulums, but you know what? It gets the job done, and if you want to have a good time, this is the way to do it. But yeah, that's the deck. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure you let us know that Pend is in fact the best deck in the comment section down below. Thank you so much to Triff for letting us on the channel. We always love coming back. If you want us to come back, let us know, and let us know what kind of deck profile you'd like to see us do. So make sure you subscribe to Triff, make sure you subscribe to us, and make sure you have a super duper day with whatever it is you're doing. But we love you! you. You matter. And we will see you guys on our channel, hopefully. If not, well, this is weird, but we're going to go now. Bye!